In the mantra japa, we are not using any materials in physical form. Instead, we are showing many mudras to satisfy the god or goddess. The mudras along with the relevant mantras are very powerful. With the mudras, we are touching many subtle chakras in our body. Those chakras are getting purified and energized. By this purification process, our body itself becomes very divine form. Now, we shall see how the Rishyadinyasaha are being done. If we join our thumb and ring finger, it is called Nyasa Mudra. Using this mudra, we are doing the Rishyadinyasaha. When you are telling Rishihi, touch your head with Nyasa Mudra. When you are telling Chantaha, touch the tip of your nose or upper lip. When you are telling Devata, touch the place in between your chest, where the Vedas says God is present in the subtle form. When you are telling Bijam, touch your right shoulder. When you are telling Shaktihi, touch your left shoulder. When you are telling Kilakam, touch your navel. Next, we are doing Shankalpam. This is being done to ensure for what purpose, on behalf of whom you are doing the japa. And we are involving our desired God to fulfill this japa. Place your left hand on the right thigh, facing upward. And place your right hand in the crossed manner, keeping the palm downward on the left hand palm. Now we have to recite the Sankalpa Mantra. Next we are doing Karanyasam. Using this purification process, we are cleansing our fingers and hands. By telling Angushtabhyam Namaha, we have to touch our thumb of both hands using our index fingers from bottom to top. By telling Tarjanibhyam Namaha, we have to touch our index fingers of both hands using our thumbs from bottom to top. By telling Madhyamabhyam Namaha, we have to touch our middle fingers using our thumb from bottom to top. By telling Anamigabhyam Namaha, we have to touch our ring finger using our thumb from the bottom to top. By telling Kanishchigabhyam Namaha, we have to touch our little finger using our thumb from bottom to top. Then by telling Karadala Karaprishtabhyam Namaha, we have to touch both the hands like this. Next we are doing Hridayadinyasam. While telling Hridayaya Namaha, we have to touch our heart, middle of our chest, with right hand, middle three fingers, leaving little finger and thumb. While telling Sirase Swaha, we have to touch the top of our head with middle and ring fingers. While telling Shikhayai Vashatu, we have to touch the back side of our head with right hand thumb. While telling Kavachayakum, we have to touch our body in a crossed manner like this. While telling Netratrayaya Vaushatu, we have to touch our three eyes using index, middle and ring fingers. When we are telling Astraya Fatu, we have to rotate our right hand in clockwise direction around our head and pat three times on the left palm using right hand index and middle finger. While telling Bhurbhuvasvaromiti Digbandha, in the eight sides we have to make sound using our fingers to form a circle. This is considered as mantra circle. Within this circle, no negative forces will enter, so that we won't get disturbed from any negative forces while doing our japa. Then we have to recite Dhyana Slokam by having Anjali Mudra or Namaskara Mudra. After Dhyana Sloka, we are doing Pancha Upachara Puja. While telling the mantra Gandham Samarpayami, show the mudra like this. Touch your little finger bottom using thumbs. Show this mudra before the deity. While telling Pushpaihi Pujayami, touch your thumb bottom with the index fingers. While telling Dubamaghavayami, touch your index finger bottom with your thumb. While telling Deepam Darushayami, touch your middle finger bottom with your thumb and show this mudra before the deity. While telling Amrudham Mahanaivedhyam Nivedayami, we have to touch the bottom of ring fingers with our thumb. Show this mudra before the deity. While telling Sarvopachara Pujam Samarpayami, have the Anjali Mudra. Then we have to start the mantra japa as per the Sangalpam name, either 108 times or 1008 times. To count the mantra, we can use japa mala or we can use our own right hand. When you are using our right hand to count the mantra, it is called Karamala. We will see how to count using our hands. From the middle line or middle Rekha of ring finger, we have to start as shown. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, in this place, we have to count 11, 12 in the reverse direction. When we end in the middle of ring finger, we have completed 20 counts like this: 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Like this, 5 times if we do 100 countings, we would have completed. Middle finger, middle and bottom lines or rekhas we are not touching when we are counting the mantra using karamala. Those places are called meru. After the mantra japa, again we have to do hridayadinyasam as explained previously. Then we have to recite bhurbhavasvaromi digvimogaha. While telling this mantra, we have to make sound using our fingers in 8 sides in anti-clockwise direction. By this process, we are opening the circle made previously in clockwise direction. While telling bhurbhavasvaromi digvimantra, we started from east, southeast, south, southwest, west, northwest, north, northeast. Now, when we are telling bhurbhavasvaromi digvimogaha, we have to go in anti-clockwise direction. Northeast, north, northwest, west, southwest, then south, southeast, east. Then we have to recite the Dhyana Sloka. Then again perform the Pancha Upachara Puja as explained earlier. Then by reciting Samarpana Mantra, we have to submit the fruits of the japa in the hands of God or Goddess. If it is female Goddess, we have to submit the mantra japa fruits in the left hand of the deity. If it is male God, we have to surrender the mantra japa fruits in the right hand of the male deity. If there is any error or wrong recitation of mantra, the God will correct and provide us with good results. Sarve janas sukhino bhavantu.